Jada. She praying for better days. I'm praying to take this water. Real is the stunning shit. Put that day on my mother's soul.
Sports Talk Radio, got the homie Donte on the mic with me down here in the basement. That was Young Jeezy, Hustler's Ambition. How you feeling today, Joe? You all right? You cool? You still ready? You ready to keep it going?
Yeah, I'm good.
All right, okay. This is podcast number 3 that you got going on. You dig? We just been talking about the finals, talking about a little bit of Bulls basketball, talking about old Bulls basketball, Bulls coaches. Thibodeau, still fuck Fred Hoiberg. We're gonna keep it moving that way. We're gonna keep it moving and everything else. You mentioned Noah. What you wanted to talk about with Noah, homie?
The thing with Noah is, you know, everybody getting scared that he might leave or something like that. And he made a couple comments saying that he's looking forward to free agency.
Let me ask you this before you go into, I don't mean to cut you off. Okay. The two young cats we got. Bobby Portis and what's his name? If I'm correct, me if I'm wrong, Horacio. You know who
Felicio
I'm talking about? Felicio or something like that.
Felicio.
Okay, there we go. Felicio. Do you think with Jimmy Rose is Dunleavy coming back? I gotta see. I ain't been reading up. Let's just say, for example, if Dunleavy coming back. Jimmy Rose, Dunleavy, and let's just say Noah Lee. We still got Taj.
Yeah.
Gasol, bro. Felicio showed me something that I really want to see more of. I'm not going to lie to you. He showed me something I want to see more of. You know what you're going to get out of Taj already. Portis. He can shoot the three. He can shoot the mid-range. He just got to get his offensive game under control, but he got the energy that we need. Do you think if Noah go ahead and take his baggage elsewhere, Gasol, we already saying he pretty much getting the fuck on. Do you think we got enough in the big man department to still go out there and compete?
Compete, yeah. Like you say, Felicio sold me so much time to be up there and everything. Portis was somebody I was really rooting for, and then he started doing silly shit. He needs to know.
Does do that. Crazy ass does do that.
And he needs to definitely know his spots on the floor defensively. He roams around, but he doesn't know where to roam around. And then he's got to know when to make them shots and everything like that. So you got a big banger that can't be all up on the three-point line or something like that. So they're going to need somebody to school them and to know them a veteran that's going to come cheap or something like
what,
that.
What's the short name? I don't mean to call him a short cat. Much respect. Number 55. Is I'm you know, I didn't smoke the weed. I'm going a little bit blank right now. Number 55. Yeah, what's his name? He played in Washington, man. It's gonna come to me. But anyway.
What is he, a power forward?
Nah, man, he was a guard. He said he's a power forward. Anyway, we gonna look that up, man. It's gonna come to us.
Not Holiday, is it?
No, not Holiday. Holiday won number 7. Damn, man.
Moore?
Etwan Moore.
Yeah.
That was his name, Etwan Moore. You think he should be a priority to bring back?
I mean, he comes back cheap or something like that. I mean, he didn't show flashes and stuff. He's good defensively, though.
Would you make him a priority? He was good offensively. Fuck defensive. He was good offensively.
I mean, he can shoot some mid-range shots and stuff like that.
He can hit the three.
He was on the floor and he can
He brought a spark.
So, yeah, okay. Since you said that, yeah, I'm making a priority. He's six man. Most definitely, you know. He sold a little value and everything like that. And Holiday, he can guard a lot of the superstars I see.
I like Holiday. He's raw talent, too. He's very much so raw talent. I really do like Holiday. But my main concern is us about losing these big men in that two guard, you know. But I think if it came down to it, if I was playing a game of chess and I had to sacrifice, I would more so sacrifice Noah than Jimmy.
Well, you know, you got everybody having these doubts talking about Jimmy wanting to play a good 2 years offensively, so I guess he still has to prove himself.
I would much so sacrifice Noah over Jimmy. I would see what I can get for Noah. If it came down to that, you know, like you say, didn't you just say he pretty much can go shop whatever he want to do?
Yeah, he's unrestricted free agent, so he can go out and try with anything he wants to.
So, yeah, I would pretty much...
The question with that, though.
I would pretty much sacrifice that.
If he goes to Minnesota, you think he's going to start over Towns? No. I don't think so.
I think he would.
I couldn't see that, though.
That's veteran over you.
Yeah, but that you, what, rookie of the year?
That's a proven veteran that when players have went down, he has ran that team. He has ran a team.
True.
At the center position. But at the same time, you cannot kill that mentality, though.
Kill what mentality?
The team and taking over. That's what Minnesota needs. Minnesota needs somebody that's going to come down and put things in place. The court, when Thibs can't, I think that's why Noah would be a good fit in Minnesota if we do lose.
So you don't think Garnett's going to come back, huh?
If Garnett and Noah come back together, they don't even like each other.
That's what I'm saying. But if Garnett does stick around, though, to try to mold Towns like he was doing.
Well, I mean, that's something that the organization going to have to sit Noah and Garnett down and they're going to have to discuss. But I think if Noah do leave, I think his best fit will be in Minnesota.
I would thought you'd try to go to a championship caliber team or something like that. I might sound crazy as hell, but the team that probably would need him would be Golden State. They would need him.
Golden State would have to pay a nice price. I want to see what's going to happen to that team at the end of the year. Because, you know, Barnes... I would like to see him in the Bulls uniform. I'm not going to lie to you.
I don't know. Barnes has been always... he was good when he came out of college. And then when they started adding more pieces, he started disappearing. Yeah, he's part of the team, but he wasn't what he was doing when he first got there. Did he get drafted before Thompson?
Who?
Barnes.
Shit, I don't know, man. I told you, I don't pay attention to no goddamn draft, man.
I'm looking at this on the aspect of, I remember knowing Barnes and seeing Barnes play, and when he was real young.
I think Barnes did get drafted before Thompson.
Barnes was actually a piece that they thought was going to be a superstar, too. And then when Thompson and then Curry really started gelling, then the Splash Brothers, he added, but he wasn't part of that tangent. Like, let's say when TMC was up there, nobody knows that's... Chris Mullin.
To my run TMC?
Yeah, but you looking at those three, like that was their squad right there.
Mm-hmm.
Barnes, it's like, oh, he really disappeared, especially when Green came about. So he's just playing role player. When I know inside he wants to practice how to be a superstar, but to me he ain't proven. And like I say, he's been lost in the mist for a couple years now.
So you don't think Barnes would be a good addition?
That's if we lose Dunleavy. I mean, I think McDermott should be starting if he does leave Dunleavy. And if he comes off the bench, maybe. But, no, I'm not going to make him my starter. I think McDermott is real shine this year. Watch what I tell everybody.
I'm not too hung on McDermott, but going to come back in y'all here. Got a little music for y'all. It goes down in the DM.
The Bentley truck with photos already on the way. We already got the motherfucking G-Wagon with the six wheels.
I seen your girl post a BM.
Let's go. Got
so
it.
I hit her in the DM.
Rosé. Memphis.
All eyes, yeah, I see
305. Dope boys,
yeah,
what's
that's
up?
Your man, I hate to be
what's
him.
Up, baby?
It goes down in the DM.
It go down
in the DM.
It go down, it go down.
She deserve a rich nigga, you hear me?
It go down in the DM.
Baby girl skin looking so smooth. Had they hit that follow button like, ooh. And I never read your bio, baby. Change your life, I had that shit redecorated. Relocated, breath of fresh air, yeah, that's how we say it. Lingerie 3 times a week is how you gotta play it. Burped off the Sephora, that's for a first trip. Bora Bora, a new foreign was the first whip. Biggest boss, she retweet all of my gangster shit. She verified, never questioned the true gangster, bitch. She got a nigga, but I really feel she fit for me. Hitchhiking never got me richer where I need to be.
It goes down in the DM.
It
go down in the DM.
It go down, it go down.
It goes down in the DM.
It go down.
It go down in the DM.
It go down, it go down.
Don't you hate when you get screenshotted? Bitch, that DM one for everybody. Rules. I love the gram, I love the gram,
I love the gram.
I'm addicted to it, I know I am,
I know I am.
And I just follow Angela
Simmons.
Boy, I got a crush on Angela
Simmons.
They like, damn, got it, you bold.
Bold.
Fuck it, I'm gonna let the world know. Go. I seen your girl post a BM. So I hit her in the DM. All eyes, yeah, I see him. Yeah, this your man, I hate to be him. It goes down in the DM.
It go down.
It go down in the DM.
It go down. It go down.
It goes down in the DM.
It go down.
It go down in the DM.
It go down.
I tell
it go down.
Snapchat me that pussy. Move.
Snapchat me that pussy if it's cool.
Snapchat me that pussy.
Snatch at me that pussy if it's cool.
I seen your girl post a BM. So I hit her in the DM. All eyes, yeah, I see him. Yeah, this your man, I hate to be him.
Bring A Game Sports Talk Radio. I'm back in your ear right here. Blaq Hippie Radio Entertainment. Me and the homie Donte sitting right here in the basement talking a little bit of sports. We're talking about the finals. Everything else, man. If y'all check out the sports group and everything else, just go on Facebook. It's Bring Your A Game Sports Talk Radio Plus.
Don't be afraid. You know, jump on there. Y'all got opinions on the page. Y'all got to express
exactly
your opinion.
Exactly. And don't forget the website. Go ahead and Google that. Just type it on Google. You can go ahead and check out. I'm going to add more smaller commentary. Get Donte to get on there and write and everything else. You know, put his opinions up there. Put more videos up there, you know. And you, the people that's in the group, y'all can go ahead and y'all can start commenting.